Hey guys, it's Adam here. Just a quick intro before we get on with our feature presentation. What you're about to watch, hopefully, is what I'm calling Back to the Future 4. Essentially, what I did was I took this game, Back to the Future, the game by Telltale Studios, specifically the PlayStation 4 version, and over the course of about 2 months, I was able to comprise the footage and edit it into a feature-length film. However, the original game contains a lot of extra content, and I think it's a great game, and I highly recommend you guys check it out. So I had to cut out a lot of things to make that work, but there's actually so much content that there's actually going to be a sequel called Back to the Future 5 that I'll be releasing a week after I release this video. So it goes without saying that I do not own the original content. It is the property of Telltale Studios and Universal Studios. It doesn't belong to me. It doesn't belong to FigureItOut Productions, my company. And one short disclaimer here, you have to have seen the original Back to the Future trilogy, hopefully recently, in order to really enjoy this to its fullest potential. So without further ado, please enjoy.
I'm ready.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing on the parking lot at Twin Pines Mall. It's Saturday morning, October 26th, 1985, 1:18 a.m., and this is temporal experiment number one. Come on, Einy. Hey, boy, get in there. That a boy. In you go. Get down. Get your seatbelt on. That's it.
Whoa. Okay.
Please note that Einstein's clock is in precise synchronization with my control watch. Got it?
Right, check, Doc.
Good. Have a good trip, Einstein. Watch your head.
You got that thing hooked up to the car?
Watch this.
Yeah, okay. Got it.
Not me. The car. The car. My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit. Watch this.
What did I tell you? 88 miles per hour!
The temporal displacement occurred at exactly 1:20 a.m. and 0 seconds!
Hot Jesus Christ! Jesus Christ, Doc! You disintegrated Einstein!
Calm down, Marty! I didn't disintegrate anything! The molecular structure of both Einstein and the car are completely intact!
Where the hell are they?
The appropriate question is, when the hell are they? You see, Einstein has just become the world's first time traveler! I sent him into the future! And at precisely 1:21 a.m. and 0 seconds, we shall catch up with him and the time machine!
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine? Out of a DeLorean?
The way I see it, if you're gonna build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style? Besides, the stainless steel construction made the flux dispersal. Look out!
Doc?
That's peculiar.
Where's the car, Doc?
It should have caught up with us 27 seconds ago.
Doc, what happened, Einstein?
No need for concern. It's probably just a minor miscalibration of the time circuits. Marty, could you get my notebook? It should be in the toolbox.
Notebook. Got it. Flux capacitor?
That's it!
What the heck's a flux capacitor?
My latest invention. The thing that makes time travel possible. In this notebook, I've detailed the nearly 3 decades of scientific breakthroughs necessary to build a working time machine.
Doc, something's way off here. Doc?
Great Scott!
Doc, what is it?
I've made a horrible mistake!
Doc! Doc, no!
I'm sorry, Marty.
Doc, come back! Doc! Doc!
Marty, is everything okay?
Yeah, Mom, it was just a nightmare. I was in the past, and Doc was there.
Well, you're safe and sound now, back in good old 1986. But you'd better get up. Your father's waiting for you.
Huh?
Weren't you going to meet him over at Doc's?
Holy crap, I'm late! Dad, are we too late to stop the sale?
Better late than never. You wouldn't believe how much rare stuff there is back here.
That's Doc's stuff. The city has no right
to... Now, son, I know you're upset, but your friend's been gone for months, and the city really seems hell-bent on using his land for that new parking garage. And, hey, is that a first edition Jules Verne?
It's just not fair. But at least things can't get any worse.
Hey, Marty.
Hi, Biff.
Come to see if the old crackpot had any buried treasure?
Nah, I guess I'm just... remembering.
Hey, let me!
Now, Biff, leave Marty alone. This is a very emotional time for him.
Oh, sure! Sorry, Marty!
Hey, Dad, why's my guitar got a price tag on it?
Sorry, son. Must have been an overzealous clerk. Just pick it up, I'll iron things out with the bank.
About Biff, Dad, I know you're trying to help.
He talks a big game, son, but he's not so tough. I've been dealing with him a long time. Believe me, I can handle him.
So can I.
Okay, son, I'll stay out of your way. You know where to find me.
Doc built this model at downtown Hill Valley way back in 1955. What the?
Hey, that looks just like the courthouse. You gotta hand it to the old coot. He was good with his hands.
Biff, can I see that a minute?
This would look great in my fish tank. Give the old carp something new to nibble on.
Can I see that model courthouse for just a second? I need to get something out of it.
Like what? A not guilty verdict? That was a joke.
Oh, ha. But really, can I?
Nah, I think I'll hold on to it.
Give it here, Biff.
Well, well, looky what we have here. Looks like plans for something. What's a flux catheter?
It's none of your business. Doc asked me to...
Brown's worm food, kid. But this looks like it might be worth something.
It's just a notebook with Doc's scribblings. What did Doc ever accomplish?
Nothing.
And then it's worthless, right?
If it was really worthless, you wouldn't want it so bad.
I only want that notebook because, well, I'm sentimental. It's like a piece of Doc.
Doc's dead. Time to get over it and move on.
I'll pay you for it.
How much? Not enough.
Never mind.
Problem? Biff?
He's got this thing, see, and I really need to get it back.
If he stole something from you...
No, it's one of Doc's notebooks. He found it first, but...
Oh, well, then I'm not sure what to tell you. I guess you'll just have to appeal to his better angels or something.
Or something. Here's an oldie, but a goodie. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, look! It's Chuck Butthead. Let me show you how it's done.
Whatever you say. Whoa! Rock on, Biff.
Oh, shit.
Doc, where are you? Einstein! Where do you come from, boy? Didn't you bring Doc with you? Doc, I know I haven't seen you in a few months, but I'm pretty sure this isn't your shoe. Automatic retrieval?
In case of my failure to return to the DeLorean within an allotted time, I programmed the time machine to jump to these four-dimensional coordinates without me. As you are well aware, time travel is an inherently risky activity, and despite my elaborate precautions, there's always a possibility that I could land in trouble sometime, and that sometime is now, or then, or maybe later.
He's in trouble!
Marty, you've come to my rescue in the past. Or was it the future? Anyway, I'm relying on you to do it again. Please take the DeLorean back, or forward, to whatever it is I'm stuck in time. When you get there, I'm sure you'll figure out what to do.
That's it? Right, last time departed. Oh, jeez. Come on. Crap! Oh, great. How am I supposed to find him now? What do you know about this, Shuiney? Great Scott! I think he's onto something! How's this supposed to lead me to Doc, Einie?
Step away from the door!
Ah.
Hooligans! Get along now! Scat!
I'm not a hooligan, ma'am. I'm a teenager.
I wasn't born yesterday, young man. Aren't you the miscreant who skateboards through the town square every morning between 8 and 8:30 in a decidedly unpunctual manner?
Yeah?
All skateboarders are hooligans. It's a fact. Look it up. State your business, child.
Well, see, that's the thing. I'm not sure why I'm here. Einstein here brought me. I've got something to show you.
What is it? Let me see. A shoe? Wow, now what would I want with a... Huh? Stay there! Please.
Sorry, Einstein.
Well, took you long enough.
There's a lot of stairs.
To return the shoe, I mean. I lost it ages ago. You can put it down next to the other one. Much better. So neat and orderly. I suppose you'll be wanting some sort of reward now.
No, I...
All I've got is tea and candy.
But...
I'm sorry I called you a hooligan. I try not to jump to conclusions, but after all, 9 out of 10 people in this city are hooligans. It's a fact. Look it up. Have a seat, Sonny.
Hey! You kids! Put out those cigarettes!
What's with all these newspapers?
This is my personal archive. I've got every issue of the Hill Valley Telegraph ever published.
Get out. Every single issue?
From 1871 to the present. If it happened in Hill Valley, you'll find it in my stacks.
Do you remember when you lost your shoe?
Shoe?
That shoe over there.
Yes, I remember. I lost it in a scuffle with a dog.
Oh, when was it?
Oh, yes. The day that speakeasy burned down.
That must have been wild. Is it true they used to drink gin out of slippers like my grandma said?
Don't romanticize the past, young man. Prohibition was a time when gangsters ruled the town well. Honest citizens quaked in their beds.
So where was it?
If you're looking for bootleg hooch.
No, I'm just curious, that's all. I'm a student of history.
Student of history? My Aunt Fanny! Yeah, your generation of hooligans and slackers could give two ripe figs about history.
Miss Strickland?
Oh, video store!
Huh?
The speakeasy used to be hidden in plain sight down there in the town square. Right where that disgusting videotape rental store squats today.
So the video store building must have gone up after the speakeasy burned down.
The following year, as I recall.
And if I take a look?
Go ahead, dear.
Man, these are powerful. I could see Biff going into the video store.
Yeah, you wouldn't believe the filth that boy watches. He's nothing but an out-of-control hedonist. Just like his father.
Rebuilt in February 1932.
Don't touch those! My newspapers are in pristine condition and meticulously organized.
What are these?
My editorial trophies.
Cat Lovers Quarterly.
It's legitimate journalism.
Is that Vice Principal Strickland?
Mother never could keep little Gerald out of her clothes.
Marshall Strickland.
My grandfather, gunned down by Mad Dog Tannen over 100 years ago.
That's not how I remember it.
That's the kettle. I'll be right back with some tea. Then don't touch anything!
Let's see. Ground broken on site of former speakeasy. Singer vanishes. Hill Valley Expo delights crowd. Soup kitchen exposed. Here we go. Speakeasy arsonist slain. Legal procedure gave way to old-fashioned vengeance last night when a mob descended on the Hill Valley police station. The suspect in the speakeasy arson case, a drifter known as Carl Sagan, was pulled from his... Carl Sagan? It's Doc! Killed by a mob. What's the date? June 14th, 1931. Jeez, I gotta rescue him.
My newspapers!
Sorry, Miss Strickland.
No! You've gotten my history out of order! Oh, do you know how long it'll take to fix what you've done? Oh, get out! Get out! Get out!
Police! I'm being attacked by hooligans!
Marty, where you been, son? And what are you doing in that getup?
Didn't I tell you? I got a job.
At the Model T factory?
Yeah. No.
Never mind, you don't have to explain. I'm sure whatever it is you're up to, you know what you're doing, right?
I hope so.
Hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love, right? Wish my dad had understood that. You won't stay away too long.
You'll barely know I was gone. You ready to go, Einstein? If Doc's gonna get killed on June 14th, 1931, I'll just show up the day before and get him out. I hope you know what you're doing, Doc.
Young man! Excuse me, young man!
Who? Me?
You're the only man in the street, and I'm looking for a man-in-the-street reaction. Naturally, you know about the explosion that destroyed this illegal gin establishment.
I read about it, yeah.
What's your opinion of Carl Sagan, the stranger who single-handedly did what the law has been unable to do for 10 long years, namely, rid Hill Valley of the scourge of liquor?
You can mark me down as a supporter.
The young man said, flashing a boyish yet virile grin. Hill Valley needs more upstanding youths like yourself. Do you have a message for the vicious gangsters who still roam these streets, no doubt plotting to corrupt our citizens with another den of booze, sin, and debauchery?
No, not really.
That's the spirit! Destroy them with indifference! If we refuse to patronize their establishments and glorify their wicked exploits, they'll soon be exposed for the pathetic wretches they are! May I get your name?
Michael Corleone.
Thank you for sharing your candid opinions, Mr. Corleone. Edna Strickland, Hill Valley Herald.
I know. I met you back. I mean, I'm familiar with your work.
You read my column? How sweet! I know it's just an etiquette column, but I believe it'll lead to bigger and better... Oh!
Einstein, no! Down, boy!
Is this wretched creature yours? He assaulted me once before.
What's got into you?
Aggressive dogs must be kept on leash at all times. It's the law. Look it up.
Doc, I gotta find Doc. Hill Valley Police Station. Cripes, this place looks old, even for 1931. Doc!
Art!
Doc!
What are you doing here?
You sent for me, Doc.
I did? When?
May 14th, 1986.
1980? The automatic retrieval system, of course. I'd almost forgotten about that.
Where'd the DeLorean come from? The last time I saw it had been smashed to pieces by a train.
Do you remember when the DeLorean got struck by lightning in 1955?
Yeah.
Unbeknownst to either of us, the lightning produced a temporal duplicate of the time machine, one that was tossed 70 years into the future.
What?
I found out about it during a trip to 2025 and recovered it just in time to stop Griff Tannen from vandalizing the time stream.
So that DeLorean...
is for all intents and purposes the exact same machine as the original. Plus or minus little bells and whistles I've added over the years, of course.
How'd you wind up in jail in 1931 anyway?
During my trip to the past, I decided to look into one of Hill Valley's unsolved mysteries.
The fire at the speakeasy.
Exactly. I thought I was safely hidden across the street. But when the fire started, there was a tremendous explosion, and I was knocked unconscious by a stray brick. When I woke up, I was here in jail, charged with arson.
That's horrible.
I know. Worse yet, I still don't know who started the fire.
So what's our plan for getting you out of here?
Plan? We don't need a plan.
We don't.
Not in the slightest. The DA hasn't got a case. They're releasing me tomorrow morning.
So basically, I traveled 50 years into the past to deliver your car?
Sorry about that, but it's so wonderful to see you. We have a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah, you might want to hold off on that, Doc.
Great Scott! I'm going to be gunned down by gangsters on the steps of the courthouse!
Why would they do that?
Guess they didn't approve of my burning down their speakeasy.
Very funny, Doc. Maybe now we should come up with a plan.
Right! But what?
Why don't I take the DeLorean, go back in time before you were arrested, and stop you from getting caught in the first place?
Don't even think about it. Without my unjust incarceration, the events that sent you into the past might never happen, resulting in a paradox of continuum-shattering proportions.
Jeez, we've been back together for 5 minutes, Doc, and you're already talking about the end of the universe. I've missed that.
I was only referring to the end of the universe as we know it.
Well, I suppose I could just get some dynamite and break you out of jail.
No, that's far too dangerous. Not just to me, but to random innocent people in the past. The repercussions could be... That's it!
What's it?
My rocket-powered drill.
You've lost me, Doc.
Listen, a few months ago, my 17-year-old self sent in a patent application for a rocket-powered drill. I abandoned the project after I never heard back from the patent office, but the prototype should be nearly complete.
Great, I'll just run back to your lab and...
No, I said nearly complete. You'll need me to help you finish it.
How the hell am I supposed to sneak a half-finished rocket-powered drill into your cell?
Not me! 1931 me!
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to convince your 1931 self to build a rocket-powered drill to break you out of jail?
Precisely!
How am I supposed to convince your younger self to...
Just be your charming self. From what I remember, I'm a pretty easygoing kid, so enlisting me in a scientific adventure should be a piece of cake.
Where can I find you? I mean, the other you.
How should I know? It was over 50 years ago. Why don't you go over to the soup kitchen next door and give my house a call? They'll know where to find me.
Soup kitchen. Got it. I guess I better get started. McFly! Biff? Kid! Grandpa?
That's Mr. Tannen to you, Artie. What are you doing out here?
Well, I was getting kind of hungry, so I figured I'd come down here for some free soup.
Just thought I'd come down for some soup. Think, McFly! The DA's throwing around subpoenas like Babe Ruth.
I don't think Ruth's a pitcher anymore.
Shut it! If one of those subpoenas landed in the hands of my number cruncher, I'd be in a whole lot of trouble. I could even get sent up the river. You wouldn't want that, would you? Would you?
No, of course not, kid.
All right, that's better. What are you looking at, punk?
Keep your eyes on the soup, kid.
Well?
Well, what?
What are you still doing here?
Sorry, kid, I'll just... run back to the safe house.
You do that. And McFly?
Yes?
That hat's too flashy. You better let me hold on to it. Now scram!
You got it, boss.
And don't come out until I give you the all clear. I swear, if even one of you mooks could add 2 plus 2 without your fingers, I'd dump that wimp into the lake. Hey! Anyway, I'm off to make myself irresistible. Don't let anyone burn down the shop while I'm gone.
Hey, cue ball.
What?
The truck just arrived with a fresh shipment of, soup.
Soup?
Well, this is the regular soup, and this is the special soup.
Right. Special.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm spicing up the soup. It's my secret recipe.
Listen, this ain't the Savoy, and we ain't here to feed these bozos no fancy soup. The boss has got a business to rebuild, so knock off the goofing and mind your post.
All right, just try the soup.
Well?
I can see why you want to keep this a secret.
Brown residence?
Hi. Do you know where I could find Emmett Brown?
Young Master Brown is currently tending to his clerking duties at the courthouse. I see his calling.
Courthouse? Doc never told me he worked at the courthouse.
Don't touch those! These are very sensitive legal documents. Nobody is supposed to handle them but sworn officers of the court. Judge Brown says so.
Judge Brown? Doc. Nice to meet you. I'm Michael, Corleone.
Emmett Brown. But I am a law clerk, not a doctor. Now please get out of my way. I have important business to transact.
What's this important business you're up to?
It's a legal matter. Very complicated, very abstruse. I need to obtain 5 sets of initials on every copy of this writ of indemnification before Judge Brown can even think of granting a waiver to the party in the first part.
You have no idea what it's about, do you?
That's how important it is.
I understand you're working on a new invention in your lab.
Invention? You must have me mixed up with somebody else. I'm in law. I have absolutely no interest in science.
Listen, we all keep secrets, but I'm telling you, you can level with me about this science project of yours.
I am not a scientist. Go ahead, ask me what E equals.
What does E equal?
I have absolutely no idea. See? I don't know where you got your information from about me, mister, but you're wrong. Oh, think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Doc!
Morty! How goes the escape plan?
Well, I met your younger self.
Great!
And I gotta say, you're kind of uptight.
I find that hard to believe.
He says he's not a scientist.
What? Father.
What's he got to do with this?
In 1931, I was still deathly afraid of my father discovering the truth about my scientific predilections. So I carefully kept them under wraps, practicing science at odd hours, away from his prying eyes.
That sucks.
It sucked a lot. Fortunately, I eventually stood up to him. But right now, my younger self probably thinks you've been sent by my father to check up on me.
Why does your younger self mutter all the time?
Muttering? Why would I be muttering? I never mutter unless... the Hill Valley Expo!
The Expo?
Yes, the Expo. How could I have forgotten? In a few months, the younger me will put on a demonstration at the Hill Valley Exposition, my first public foray into the world of science. Everyone in town will be there, including a number of noted inventors who shaped my career.
So, it was a big success?
No, it was a miserable failure, but it was a spectacularly miserable failure, one which marked my transition from an amateur garage scientist into a professional seeker of truth.
What does this expo have to do with you muttering all the time?
When I was younger, I used to relieve stress by working on complex mathematical conundrums. No doubt my younger self is working on some impossible problem in an attempt to work off cerebral steam in the weeks before the exposition. What was I muttering about?
Oh, think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Good grief! Is that me? I sound so...
young?
I was gonna say intense.
Yeah, but...
just tell my younger self that H equals a Hamiltonian operator.
Guess who I bumped into at the soup kitchen? My grandfather.
No!
Don't worry, I didn't talk to him or change his future or anything.
Good!
What's the story with this kid Tannen jerk, anyway?
Biff's father? By this time next year, he'll be pulling down a life sentence in San Quentin. There was even a song about it.
Wait, if Biff will be born in 1938, and Kid will be in prison...
As I recall, he escaped from prison in 1937 for about 3 hours.
That's a busy 3 hours.
No kidding.
Hang in there, Doc.
Not the best choice of words, Marty.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Corleone.
Maybe H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
Great Scott! If H is the Hamiltonian, then H to the A multiplied by the inverse of H can only be the same as the expectation value for A. Ha ha! That's it! That's the solution to Ivanov's conundrum, the problem I've been wrestling with in my head all week!
I'm sure you would have figured it out by yourself in a day or two. The way you figured out how to build that rocket-powered drill.
Where did you learn so much about... science?
Well, it's like this.
You know about my rocket power drill? Then there can only be one explanation.
What?
You're from the patent office! I confess I didn't quite know what to expect when I sent the paperwork, but I never expected this. Welcome! I'm at your service. What can I do for you?
Can I see your rocket power drill?
Of course, of course! Naturally, it's just a scale model, but it's nearly operational. I can show it to you, say, first thing in the morning?
Nah, that's no good. I need to see a full-size model. That's fully operational. Tonight. Otherwise, we'll have to award the patent to a competing inventor, Dr. McCoy.
It can't be done! I mean, it might be possible to construct a full-size working model in that time frame, but I haven't got the main ingredient for the fuel.
I'll get it for you. What is it?
190-proof grain alcohol. And you know how difficult it is to get a hold of alcohol these days.
Especially now that someone's blown up the speakeasy.
And besides, there's no way I can get off work until I've delivered the subpoena. It's part of the investigation into the business affairs of Kid Tannen. Is it vitally important you see that rocket-powered drill today?
Yes. Is it vitally important you deliver that subpoena today?
Yes!
Listen, I'll help you deliver it, and I'll see to it you get the alcohol you need. It'll help you get that drill finished by tonight. Deal?
Deal. Here's the subpoena.
Arthur McFly?
It's Kid Tannen!
Hey, I just saw him at the soup kitchen, yelling at Arthur McFly.
I'm not surprised. Arthur does the books for his business.
What kind of business?
That's what the DA is trying to find out.
Let's go talk to him.
No!
Why not? Kid Tannen can tell us where Arthur's hiding.
Yeah, well, he can also have us fitted for a Chicago overcoat.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone. Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
What's the scoop?
I've heard rumors that something shady is going on at the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen. It's under new management, you know. And, oh, we mustn't jump to any conclusions. Not till the facts are in. I hope to heaven it is just a rumor. That soup kitchen is the front line in the good fight. If it goes bad, what will happen to the Stay Sober Society? Not to mention all the charitable institutions that depend on me for soup deliveries. I pick up barrels of hot soup at the kitchen, and I deliver them hither and thither.
What's the Stay Sober Society?
You haven't heard of the SSS? They do the most marvelous work, taking hopeless drunken bums and turning them into former hopeless drunken bums. I'm one of the founding members. And not to say that I was ever, well, you know. Anyway, we've always met in the cellar of the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen, but for some reason the new managers don't want us down there, so we're stuck. We've got nowhere to meet.
I got a book.
You got kiwi all over my socks!
Where?
Sorry, boss.
Get out of here. How about you?
Huh?
Either you're here to shine my shoes, or you got a death wish. Which is it?
Isn't that Arthur McFly's hat you're holding?
It was McFly's hat. Now, it's my peanut bowl.
I guess you won't talk about your business.
Why not? I got nothing to hide. I recently acquired controlling interest in the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen.
Isn't a soup kitchen an odd line of business for a guy like you?
I like soup. Plus, I got a heart as big as all outdoors. Buff a little harder. I want to see myself in the toes.
How come you won't let the Stay Sober Society hold their meeting in the cellar of your soup kitchen?
We got other plans for that cellar, and it don't necessarily involve staying sober.
Can I have some peanuts?
Why not? I'm a magnanimous kind of guy. Go ahead, knock yourself out.
Hey, kid!
Yeah?
What the hell is that?
Hey! What are you doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now! Einstein! Help! Lay off! Get away from me, you crazy mutt!
Go away, dog! We're busy here! Go on, scram! Hey! Where'd he go?
You let him get away, idiot! Hey, honey. Come here for a sec, boy.
Where's he going?
Only one way to find out. Huh. Deja vu. He won't come out if he knows why we're really here.
Yeah? Who is it?
It's McFly!
Shh, I know!
What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
It's Kid! Right away, boss! Where's Kid?
Arthur McFly?
Yeah?
Got something for you.
Thanks! A subpoena?
Ordering you to appear in court and provide evidence in the investigation into...
Kid Tannen! Take it back!
You can't get rid of it, Mr. McFly. Once you've been served, it's your duty to report to the court at the earliest possible time. Failure to do so could lead to a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest? But Kid'll kill me. Stupid Artie. Holy cats, what am I gonna do?
I suggest you avail yourself to the protection of the court.
Oh gosh.
Oh, I hate doing stuff like that. But I won't have to much longer.
No?
Once we get that 190-proof alcohol and build my rocket drill, my future will be set and I'll be able to quit this crummy job.
Oh, right. Huddle up, Emmett.
Huddle?
I can't get into the door over there. Those tables are jamming it shut.
The door? So your plan is to just waltz in there and take a barrel of alcohol?
No. Of course not. That would be stupid, right?
I'll say.
Still, I'd like to get that door open. I can't do anything from out here.
Well, it's a simple matter of physics. A lever, some sort of stop. Let me see what I can come up with.
So this place used to be a soup kitchen.
What do you mean, used to be? Despite recent changes in ownership, this joint is still available for the purposes of distributing food to the needy and the not-so-well-to-do. And no other purposes whatsoever.
Could I have a bowl of soup?
We're a soup kitchen. What do you think?
What kind of soup is this? It tastes like...
Brulee Ribolita?
I was gonna say week-old cabbage.
Everyone's a critic. Look, all I got to work with is this two-bit soup in a barrel and spice rack that hadn't been restocked since the Coolidge administration. What do you think I should do to perk this slop up?
A little heat, maybe?
Why, is it getting cold?
No, I mean, like chili powder. Muy caliente.
Oh, bit of a tough guy, huh? Actually, I like it spicy, too. But it's gotta be edible for the common folks.
Come on, a little dash isn't gonna kill anyone.
Aw, heck. You got moxie, kid. Let's spice it up a bit, shall we? Miss Strickland, come for some more soup?
Come now, Mr. Donnelly. You know I wouldn't set one foot in this mockery of all that is good and decent if the poor of Hill Valley weren't so dependent on Mr. Tannen's overblown show of generosity.
Was that a yes?
Just give me the soup before I gag on the hypocrisy.
I'll tell the boss you said hello.
I'll just bet you will.
Edna picked up the barrel of hooch. Now all I have to do is to get it from her somehow.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone.
I'm afraid I haven't much time. The meeting of the Stay Sober Society is due to begin very soon.
Hey, I can help you deliver soup. I donate a lot of time to charities.
Oh? Which ones?
The, Mario Brothers.
Ah, yes. The Italians do so many good works.
If you'll just fix it
I drive the soup cycle in this town, and I'm not about to turn it over to an upstart. We do generally provide refreshments for the Stay Sober Society, but I'm afraid they may not be able to meet tonight. They haven't got a meeting space.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
The Brown residence.
You mean Judge Brown's place?
Yeah, I happen to be good friends with his son, Emmett. And he's told me the judge would love to lend his place out for, you know, good causes like yours.
Really? Why, that's the most generous, public-spirited offer I've received in a month of Sundays. We accept. I can't get over the generosity of your friend, Emmett, volunteering his father's house for our meeting.
Huh? Wait there! Michael! What in the name of Thomas Alva Edison do you think you're doing?
Don't you get it? You need alcohol to run your drill, right? Those bootleggers at the soup kitchen won't let us get our hands on any of their hooch. But we can get Miss Strickland to pick it up for us and deliver it right to your door.
No, out of the question.
Why?
I can't just let strangers invade my parents' house. What do we know about these people?
They're sober. It says so right in the name.
But it's still impossible.
Okay, forget the whole thing. We don't have to test your rocket-powered drill tonight.
We don't?
No, I'll take the train back to Washington and I'll tell the folks at the office to give the patent to Dr. McCoy.
Wait! You will instruct the members of the society to wipe their feet before they come inside.
Then you are Emmett Brown. I thought as much. You have such a righteous face. Edna Strickland, I don't know how to thank you for your generosity.
Oh, pleased to meet you.
The feeling is mutual.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You worry too much, Emmett. Are you sure this is gonna work, Emmett?
Don't let the ramshackle nature of my laboratory fool you. If all goes according to plan, we'll soon be in possession of the most powerful rocket fuel known to man.
That's great. How?
Well, it's very simple. This crankshaft induces a powerful direct current into the electrolysis chamber, producing hydrogen, which must be periodically released into the primary distillation barrel. While tending to the hydrogen, we'll also need to regularly sprinkle these shredded protein flakes into this aquarium of tuber bacteria to generate the necessary nitrogen to catalyze the reaction.
Cool.
No, hot! Extremely hot! The temperature of the reaction must be kept at a steady temperature of 623 degrees Kelvin by carefully pumping these bellows! Any questions?
Emmett? Why is there a brace of drunkards gathering on our lawn?
Sweet fancy Moses, it's my father!
So?
So, he doesn't know I'm engaging in acts of scientific exploration in here. He thinks this is where I go to pour through my law books.
Oh.
You tend to the reaction, I'll try to get rid of him!
Tend to the... what? Can't we just start over after he's gone?
It's too late! The reaction's already started!
Emmett!
Coming, father! Father!
Don't you father me, child!
You have no idea what kind of pressure I'm under. Don't you have a release valve on your mouth somewhere? I'm afraid we'll have to take this up later, Pop. My soup's about to boil over.
What? This isn't over, young man.
Whew.
Are you okay? You and your dad sounded...
It was an argument we should have had a long time ago. We... No!
What?
Eureka! Now all we gotta do is fuel up the old rocket power drill and you and I can...
I can take it and go.
But don't you want to test it first?
No time. The last train for DC leaves in just a few minutes.
All right. When can I expect to hear back from the patent office?
Oh, in about, I'd say... I can't.
Huh?
Emmett, I'm not from the patent office.
I don't understand.
I lied to you, but I didn't want to. It was the only way I can get you to trust me. See, there's somebody who's in big trouble. Someone very important to me, to both of us. I can't tell you who, but I need to save him tonight, and I need your invention to do it. I'll get it back to you, I promise. And, Emmett, you're gonna be a great inventor.
Wait! Keep the throttle at about 8.
Okay, Doc, I got the drill. Now let's get you out of here. Come on, start! Not supposed to be. Doc!
They're moving him to another facility for safekeeping. Oh, I better go get a quote from the police chief.
Paddy wagon intercepted. Suspect slain. And they're still after him. Coming, Doc. I've got to get you out of here.
What's that?
I said you're still in danger.
Never mind. Get me out of here and we'll talk later.
Kid Tannen's driving the truck.
Kid Tannen? That explains a lot.
Don't worry, Doc. I'll get you out.
Be careful, Marty.
need a distraction.
Leave it to me! Hey, driver! Watch how you take those curves, and I find this seat distinctly uncomfortable. You have a pillow I can sit on? Hey, I'm talking to you, driver. Don't ignore me.
You! Stand back, Doc.
Marty!
Eat lead, Sagan! Ow! Son of a bitch!
Oh! This is a rescue!
That's the idea!
Oh! I had a suspicion. I never could keep those rockets from exploding.
So, what do we do now?
Now we get back to 1986 before our interactions with the past inevitably cascade into a calamitous future. Where'd you leave Einstein?
Doc?
He's not in the pound, is he?
No, but I think we've got bigger problems right now.
Great Scott!
What's happening?
I don't know. Unless... tomorrow's newspaper. Do you still have it?
Yeah. Local accountant beaten. Left for dead.
Local accountant Arthur McFly was severely beaten and left for dead on the steps of the Hill Valley Courthouse last night.
They're gonna kill my grandpa?
Tannen's goons, no doubt. Probably in retaliation for Arthur answering that subpoena you delivered.
What are we gonna do?
I'm not sure what we can do. According to this, your grandfather was dumped on the doorsteps of the courthouse 5 minutes ago.
My dad's picture is disappearing.
That's a time stream catching up with your grandfather's fatal wounds, which means your father will never be born, and neither will you, unless... When did you last see your grandfather?
4 o'clock, in the town square.
Let's give him enough time to make his deposition. We'll have to be careful not to run into ourselves.
That shouldn't be a problem in your case. I mean, you were in jail.
All right, let's get moving before the police find us.
Freeze! Step out of the car with your hands up. What was that?
What was what?
I heard something back there.
I think you're mistaken, officer. What's that? Off in those bushes.
Huh?
Hey!
Stop!
Doc!
No! Save your grandfather! I'll be fine until you get back.
You got it, Doc.
What was that?
$4.55. There he is.
Mr. Corleone. I was wondering if I could do a little follow-up interview with you about the plight of poor Mr. Sagan. My sources indicate that Judge Brown will be setting him free tomorrow.
I wouldn't bet on that.
What's that?
Nothing. Listen, can we talk later? I've really got to get to the courthouse right now.
Well then, carry on. And do put that vicious dog of yours on a leash, will you? We have laws about that sort of thing, you know.
Sure, no problem. Ah! Ah! Oh, come on, yesterday, Marty. Stop talking. Get moving. Einstein, what is it, boy?
Einstein!
Is it a squirrel, Einie?
You! Oh! Get this mangy animal away from me!
Come on, Einstein. Get away from the nice lady.
My shoes!
Einstein, no!
No!
Way to go, Einie. Now to get into that courthouse and grab Artie before Tana's guys. Ah! Ah!
Hey!
Oh, God. Hey!
According to my calculations, the rotary engine for a full-scale rocket drill requires 1.21 kilowatts of power. Are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on. Shouldn't we be getting on with our work? We're on a strict deadline, right?
Oh, hell. Oh, my God! What the hell is that?
What's what?
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to you.
No, I mean before, while I was walking towards you.
I wasn't talking to anyone. I was working on equations for my rocket drill.
No, I mean after. Never mind. Let's get going. You gotta come with me. Look, you're in a lot of danger.
What do you mean I'm in danger?
No time to explain, Gran. No, Artie. Just promise me you'll stay at the police station until...
Artie McFly. Just the guy we're looking for.
Hey, fellas.
Run!
Get him!
Artie, how's my favorite accountant doing?
Oh, I've been better. Oh,
I'm so sorry to hear that, McFly. Trixie, take a powder, doll. We got business to discuss.
K.O., you boys play nice now. Mwah! Nice to see you again, Artie.
You too, Miss Trotter.
Yeah, yeah, we're all happy as clams. Now scram! Are you guys stupid? What are you thinking, bringing this fish food to my doorstep?
We just thought
that was your first mistake. Thinking. Look at me. Do you ever catch me thinking? Huh? Don't answer that. Look, just drag him inside, find out what he told the DA, then get rid of him.
I think we can handle that.
Good. Now, if you don't mind, I've got an arsonist to snuff out. And will one of you slobs start hauling these crates in?
We're on it, kid.
Oops. Here goes nothing.
Get the crates, cue ball. Stir the soup, cue ball. Clean out the bloodstains, cue ball. Shit, I'm not a gangster, I'm a freaking butler. Jeez, for a gal with no arms, you sure is heavy! Whoops.
Ow! Do you mind? I'm trying to conduct a professional interrogation over here.
Where should I put this?
Just shove it behind the bar. Come on, Artie. Jeez, how much chloroform did you put on that rag anyway?
Why?
Because I'm having a hard time bringing Sleeping Beauty here around.
Let me see. Hey, Artie! We got a few questions about you and the D.A.
D.A.
You see what I'm working with here?
Seems to be catching.
Zane, wake up!
Oh, sorry, boss. The stupid cold got me wiped out.
Well, try to stay awake long enough to finish that poster, will ya? We got a club to open in a few days. And turn off that sign, would ya? dumb sleepyhead.
Hey, guys. I don't feel so...
Zane, wake up, you lazy bum!
Must have been the cold.
Cold my eye. He's been dipping into the inventory.
The inventory? Ow!
What the...
I think we blew a fuse.
Well, go up to the soup kitchen and get a new one.
Why me?
You'd rather hang around and talk to this guy, huh?
Happy days are here again.
Yeah, I'll just get that fuse.
Bam! Right in the kisser. Hey, you. Wait, do I know you?
Not for about 40 years.
Is anyone down there?
Everything's spinning.
Come on, Artie. Let's get out of here before these jerks get a chance to kill you.
Wait a minute. They were gonna kill me?
Great.
This isn't funny, guys. Is anyone down there?
Perfect timing. Hang on, Grandpa. We've got a pickup to make. Need a lift?
I thought you'd never ask. What's he doing here?
It's a long story.
Son of a...
And then I carried Artie to the DeLorean and came back to get you.
Fascinating.
So we can go home now, right?
Not yet. We still have this loose end to tie up.
No, don't tie me up again. He's coming around.
So please be careful. You won't be safe in Hill Valley as long as Kit Tannen remains at large.
Don't worry. I'm going far away from Hill Valley and I'm never coming back.
No! He's got to hook up with Grandma.
Do you know a woman named Sylvia?
No.
Well, she knows you. We'll know you. It's vitally important that you two meet.
Oh, I get it. You want me to be part of some undercover sting operation.
No, possibly.
Yeah. Are you G-Man?
Uh-huh.
Something like that.
Sure, anything for Uncle Sam. I'll stay nearby and wait for this Sylvia. But in the meantime, I'll lay low.
Good man.
When can I expect to see you again?
That was a close call.
You think he'll be okay?
You're not fading out, are you? Besides, Arthur will be completely out of danger come August 25th.
August 25th?
That's the date Kit Tannen is finally put behind bars. How's that picture of your dad?
Still there.
Good. Let's get out of here before we accidentally elect Hoover to a second term.
Well, everything looks okay.
Are you sure?
See, McFly residence. So, want to come in? Maybe hang out a while? I want my dad to see for himself that you're still around.
I'd love to, Marty, but...
You've got
to
go. I understand, Doc. You've got a life to lead, kids to raise and all that.
No, I've got to go to the bank and stop that estate sale you told me about.
Oh! See you soon, Doc. When did we get a bug zapper? Hey, anyone home? There's something wrong with my key.
Please, not now. Tomorrow. Give me another day.
Another day?
Marty.
No, that's impossible. Marty was run out of town.
Run out of town? What are you talking about, Dad? Let me in.
This is a trick. Go away.
Leave us alone. Haven't we suffered enough?
Mom.
Get Dave and Linda.
They left town years ago, which you would know if you really were Marty.
The first time he kissed Mom, it was at the Enchantment Under the Sea dance.
That's right.
Oh, my Lord. What are you waiting for, George? Let him in.
Marty! Oh, my God, Dad. What happened to you?
What do you think happened, butthead?
Biff.
I thought we told you to stay out of town, shrimp.
Biff. Whatever's going on, I'm sure we can handle it. Reasonably. Who are they?
Yeah, like you don't know Cliff and Riff.
What do you think we should do with them, baby bro? What we should have done years ago, big bro.
Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this, McFly.
Where do these other Tannins come from?
From a mommy Tannin and a daddy Tannin.
It's called the birds and the bugs, butthead.
Tannins are some kind of minor league mafia?
Hey, watch who you're calling minor league.
The Tannin gang's the fifth most dangerous crime family in California. We got connections all over the place.
No way.
You don't believe me?
Biff, no!
Bang! Check it out.
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti.
That's Don Valenti, godfather of the Sacramento mob.
The third most dangerous crime family in California.
What the hell did you do to my dad?
Your dad's been in that wheelchair since before you were born, butthead.
And you better hope he has a spare, because you're going to need one in like 3 seconds.
How long have you been coming down on my dad like this?
Ever since that school dance, when Georgie laid Biff out in the parking lot.
Shut up, it's not funny.
Someone messes with the Tannin family never lets him forget about it.
Okay, tell me this.
No more questions.
Piece of cake.
I never should have let that floozy talk me out of rubbing out your grandfather.
Huh? Kid?
No one in Hill Valley messes with the Tannin family!
Doc! Marty, get in! This timeline's been compromised!
No kidding!
Somehow, something we did in 1931 allowed Kid Tannin to escape his date with justice. As a consequence, the Tannins have been unchecked in Hill Valley for over 50 years. We've got to go back to the day Kid Tannin was supposed to be arrested. Figure out what went wrong and fix it. Otherwise, you could be forever stuck in a town owned by the Tannins.
Not an option, Doc. Punch it.
Kid Tannin is supposed to be betrayed by his mole, a singer named Pixie Trotter.
That hot babe I saw coming out of the speakeasy.
Exactly. When she does, history says Tannin will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
Parker. Hey, do you think he's related to Jennifer Parker, my girlfriend?
Could be.
Heavy.
In any event, somehow we've changed history so that neither of these events happen. You need to go back into Tannin's speakeasy. Find out what's gone wrong and get Kid Tannin arrested.
No problem, Doc. Let me just put on my hat and I'm good to go. Is the mustache really necessary?
It's essential. You can't let Kid know if you're the same troublemaker that foiled his attempt to kill me.
Are you sure you can't come in with me?
It's far too dangerous.
You may be easy to disguise with your nondescript features, but ever since my daring escape from the police and the mob, my distinctive face has been plastered over every paper from here to Reno.
Nondescript?
I'll find a safe place to hunker down. That flop house ought to fit the bill. You can find me there if you need me.
Pardon me, sir. From the way you're dressed and your general aura of seediness, I can infer only one thing. You're heading for Tannen's speakeasy, am I right?
Yeah. Can't you tell me the way?
Down. Straight down. The last stop before the inferno. Unfortunately, I don't have the power to stop you, but I beg you to tarry here a few more seconds and listen to my song. Me, 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 me. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. What in heaven's name?
Oh, sorry, Miss Strickland. Just a little experimental prototype gone momentarily awry.
Mr. Brown, why is there a dog in that vehicle?
Why? Well, to advance the human condition, of course. Hello, Mike.
Mike? Mr. Corleone, what are you doing in that getup?
I'm going undercover.
How exciting! You'll have to give me an exclusive sometime.
And you'll have to get an eyeful of my newest experiment.
You're not angry about the rocket drill?
Water over the bridge. I've moved on to bigger and better things.
How've you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you.
Really?
Yes. That argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science.
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. It's almost as if he's been working with me for years. Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this one-quarter scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
A radio-controlled car?
No. Well, yes, but that'll be so much more than that. I'll show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this! When this baby hits 23 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious cow flop.
Einstein!
No!
Get him out of there!
Not to worry. I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace.
Don't worry, Emmett. I'm sure you'll get it right someday.
Oh, I'm not worried about that. Right now, I'm more concerned with Einstein.
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Young scientist strands dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown!
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree.
Who sent you?
Ulysses S. Grant.
What did you bring me?
Meat and potatoes.
What's the word?
Words are for wimps.
This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public
safety.
You
know what represents a clear and present danger to public safety? Your singing voice.
There's no need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I'm relieved to hear it.
Who told you to come here?
Hieronymus Bosch.
What will you do tomorrow?
Row my boat.
Where did you come from?
From Russia. With love.
Welcome to L-Kids, sir.
Flying cars. Of all the ridiculous juvenile notions.
You mock me, but just imagine. A world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einie, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well, fortune favors you tonight, but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now... how to get that rocket car back down.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to once again present the hottest little number this side of the Rockies. And when I say my pleasure, I think y'all know what I'm talking about, am I right? So let's have a big L Kid welcome for the one, the only, Trixie Trotter.
You see, I'm sort of independent. I am my own superintendent. My star is on the ascendant. That's why I don't care. I don't care.
Nice suit. Where'd you get it?
Costume shop at the mall. I had it custom made.
Yeah? Quality material. Who are you? Where you from?
The name's, Michael Corleone.
Go easy, kid. From the cut of the suit, I'm thinking he might be with the Valenti gang.
Is that so?
Yes?
Prove it.
Don't even blink.
It's not a real gun. It's not a real gun, I swear. It's a gift from Don Valenti. See?
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti. Looks like little Mikey Corleone here really is with the Sacramento boys. You got stones, Pee-wee. I like that. Have yourself a drink. On the house. Matches. Put down your gun. You look like a moron.
What's your poison?
Peps, on second thought, forget it.
Suit yourself.
What are you drawing?
Another celebrity caricature.
You drew those?
Prohibition ain't gonna last forever, bub. I gotta have a skill I can fall back on when all this goes away.
Think you could do a caricature of me?
Sure. Presto!
That really doesn't look like me.
I didn't have much to work with.
What can you tell me about Trixie?
You trying to put the moves on kids, Dame?
No way.
Good, because if you did, I'd probably be hanging you on the wall of honor. Know what I mean?
Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the wall of honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
They're the guys the kids killed?
Oh, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like and that at a later date turned up dead. It's a circumstantial coincidence. Yeah.
Hey, I know you. You're...
Parker. Osifer Danny Parker. Hill Valley PD. Have we met? You look familiar.
Nah.
Well, stranger, sit down and have a drink on me.
Shouldn't you be arresting Tannen?
For what?
Well, for running a speakeasy, for one thing.
Well, I like this speakeasy. So there. Besides... If I arrested him, I'd have to arrest you and me and everyone else in here. And that's just way too much work for one little cop like me.
Should you be drinking so much on duty?
Probably not, but nobody knows the troubles I've seen.
Want to talk about them?
Oh, I don't want to wallow in misery. I came here to get happy. Hallelujah!
Hey, kid.
What is it, Squirt?
It's good to see you doing so well. The boys down in Sacramento were starting to get worried.
With all due respect, the boys down in Sacramento can bite me. When that creepy Sagan guy burned down my speakeasy, did the Sacramento boys lift a finger to help me back on my feet? No.
Well,
and when that weasel accountant McFly went and blabbed to the feds, did the Sacramento boys help me get rid of the evidence? No. But I had to put 3 more cops on my payroll to pull that one off.
Okay, but...
But nothing. When you get back to Sacramento, you let J.J. Valenti know that Kid Tannen expects a little more respect for his efforts in the future. Understand?
How long have you and Trixie been going out?
You mean knocking boots? Oh, about a year now.
That's a long time.
Tell me about it. I keep meaning to dump her for a newer model, but then she starts singing at me, and I remember why we got together in the first place.
Love?
Free nightclub entertainment!
See ya, kid.
Yeah, whatever.
Excuse me, are you Trixie Trotter?
That's what it says on my dressing room door. At least, it would if I had a dressing room.
I really like your voice.
Thanks. You should hear me when I ain't so under the weather.
You're sick?
Oh, yeah. Sore throat. That's why I'm giving Q-Ball so many extended solos tonight.
I kinda wondered about that. What's a nice gal like you doing with a guy like Tannen?
Kid ain't so bad. He just takes some...
Hey, Toots. Any chance you could sing that can-can number? The guys really love the way it shows off your, assets.
Whatever you say, kid.
And quit lazing around. I ain't paying you to yak with the drunks.
You ain't paying me at all, you bum. What were we talking about again?
You were telling me what a great guy Kid is.
Yeah, I guess he is a pretty crummy boyfriend. But until my insurance policy checks out, I guess I'm stuck with him.
Insurance?
There's only one person I trust with my secrets. But I ain't seen him in weeks.
You don't mean...
Artie McFly!
Artie McFly.
You know him?
Not as well as I thought.
Before he took a powder, Artie was tutoring me in all sorts of stuff. Etiquette, philosophy, accounting. He's a regular Renaissance man. He even had one of those smart guy professor's pipes, see?
Can I borrow this?
Sure. I've been secretly working on my get-out-of-kid card for weeks now. But Artie's the only one I trust to check my work.
Hey, if I arrange a meeting with Artie, could you use that insurance of yours?
Use it? Heck, if what I'm sitting on pans out, I could send that bozo all the way to the big house.
I'll see what I can do. Hey, Artie. He's back.
You get down from there before you hurt yourself.
Hurt myself? You're far too cautious, Miss Strickland.
Are you sure that's safe?
Of course it's not safe. That soup kitchen he's climbing is owned by gangsters.
Stop being such chickens. See? Safe as houses.
Don't blame me if you end up dead. Oh, that man is so infuriating.
You know, Trixie Trotter sings a song that sounds a lot like your You Should Care.
She does?
Yeah, but hers is a little more carefree.
That's what you get when you sing for booze hounds and gangsters.
You think I could have a copy of your You Should Care lyrics? I've, got a club of my own that could really use some inspiring.
Sure! Let me just get a page out of the hymnal. There you are.
Hey, thanks. Hey, boy, take a whiff of this. Gotta love that nose.
I've been laying low, officer, but I've got to go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But?
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Hey, Doc. How's the room?
It's a little cleaner than I would have imagined for a Depression-era flophouse.
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter, those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around out there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo. Eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Why?
During that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower and that bolt of lightning struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
I never did get a straight answer about why he came back to 1931 in the first place.
It's, personal. When this is over, I'll tell you all about it.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Just stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
It all started on June 14th. I was chasing down one of Tannen's boys when this car, straight out of Buck Rogers, popped up out of nowhere and ran my car off the road.
No.
Then later, I lost track of a witness. The poor schlub hasn't been heard from since.
That wasn't your fault.
And then, to top it off, I somehow managed to lose custody of an 80-year-old arsonist. And not one, but two of those godforsaken space cars showed up and whisked him away.
That's unbelievable.
That's what the chief said. Demoted me on the spot. My family sent me to a psychiatrist because they thought I was seeing things. And worst of all, my gal Betty left me because she thinks I'm a bad provider and a head case.
Betty? As in Jennifer's grandma Betty?
The heck with her. I got a little secret that'll set me up with women twice as classy as Betty will ever be.
You've got a secret?
Well, you're my pal, so I can tell you, but don't let it get out. I've been working for Tannen for over a month now.
What?
It's true. All I gotta do is look the other way while evidence is getting destroyed or a truck full of gin is coming across the county line. And Tannen makes sure an extra bunch of bills makes their way into my pay envelope. Great deal, huh?
Yeah, if you're a rat.
What's the problem? People need to drink, right? As long as no one's getting hurt, why shouldn't Daniel J. Parker make a few bucks on the actions? Although, that wall of fame is pretty spooky. Oh, God. I've made a horrible mistake. I thought if I could get my hands on some money, that Betty'd take me back. But when she finds out what I'd done, she'll never even talk to me again. What have I done?
Come on, Danny, pull yourself together. It's not so bad.
Not so bad? I'm a corrupt cop who's lost his only chance at true love. How's that not so bad?
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God.
Hey, Trixie, look over there!
Why?
Didn't you see it?
No.
Ah, never mind.
You should care. She's right. I can turn my life around.
Sure you can.
You know what? I used to be a good cop. And yeah, I've had a few bad breaks. Possibly even a psychotic one that caused me to imagine a disappearing space car. But I'm a good man.
Yeah.
And all I need to do to win Betty back is be the same good man I always was. And let the chips fall where they may.
All right. So, now what?
Now I wait. Wait for the moment to take down Kid Tannen, restore my good name, and win back the heart of Betty Lipinski.
Hold that thought. I bet that moment is just around the corner. Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
to... Cover for me, cue ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you?
I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate.
All right, fella. I think you're done for the night.
Hey, where do you think you're going? What do you know about this?
Nothing.
Ah! Trixie?
Break's over, cue ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that? Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head, which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then, Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live!
Huh?
Seriously, down on the knees crying and begging for McFly's life!
So, what did you do?
What could I do?
I fired 2 shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
You think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly think.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears? Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
Sorry about this, Dad. I talked to Kid.
Oh?
He told me about Artie.
Oh.
It was awesome of you to plead for his life.
And it was awesome of Kid to spare it.
What about your insurance policy?
There ain't no insurance policy. After tonight, I'm tossing it in the furnace and burning it up.
I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal. Artie was supposed to be safe.
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper! What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime... All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy?
You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Colion. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up in the next, company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean... Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are ya? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've gotta find him now.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually. Irving, Kid, Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures. Hey, Einie, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie. All right, Doc, here I come.
Corleone, come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker?
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy!
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there! Watch out!
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over! Yo, Tannen! Make like a tree and die, rat! Whoa! Bowling for tens. Hey! Hey, kid! That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Hey, he's getting away!
Oh, no.
Yes.
No. There. Good as new.
Oh, look.
Tannen.
The judge's son. All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Doc.
Marty.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Great Scott.
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I?
You! You're the cause of all of this, ain't you? Hey! Doc, hit it! Woohoo! Sagan! All right!
That's what you get for messing with Carl Sagan!
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc.
Are you absolutely sure that everything's back to normal?
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
You feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say... Let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Emmett and Edna. They're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's... odd. Great Scott! Gotta get back in. Stop your car. This could be disastrous.
Stop! Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax! We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits, until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?